Yeah, that was like,
Right, I'm here with the Dream Team standoff number six, Kurt Gidley. First thing I want to do with you, Paul, is thank you for getting together with Evans at the beginning of the season and giving that well wish for Kevin Sinfield, who read your name out today for the BBC Sports Personality. I thought that your idea was ingenious to put in a one and a three. We didn't come up with that. These guys come up with that, so thank you very much. I want to ask you about your first season in England in Super League. What's your thoughts been, and how's it compared to NRL?
Yeah, it's been really good. Look, I come here for a new challenge in my life, but also career-wise in footy, or rugby, they call it over here. So, yeah, I've certainly got that. It's been, you know, it has been a real challenge. The games have been tough, which, you know, I expected that. Playing against new opponents, different climates as well. And so, yeah, it's been really enjoyable for me. It's been really tough at times. Had some really tough games, and, you know, certainly getting to the business end of the year now. We come, all of a sudden, we're at the semi-final, and it's a win away from the grand final, which... You know, I haven't had a great deal of those during my career, so it's going to be a huge game.
It'll be massive. We're all looking forward to seeing a team like Warrington get in there. The big question is, are you going to be fit and healthy and back ready to play?
Yeah, I am. Everything's looking really positive. I was really disappointed to miss the whole game and, you know, the league leaders challenge, I suppose, between us and them over there. But I knew it was, you know, it was the right call to make. I would have been struggling to play that game. But all my rehab's gone really well last week, over the weekend, and had another run this morning, and yeah, feeling really good for this weekend now.
It's no surprise under Tony Smith tutelage that you're getting a lot of young players coming through. Patton was outstanding. The young boys have done a real job in the exclusion of yourself and Sandow not being able to play, aren't they?
Yeah, I think they have, and you know, two really important games were Catalans away after, you know, a tough Challenge Cup loss, which, you know, that was a really tough game for the, some really young guys. Playing a hot game over in Catalans, which we managed to win right at the end of the game, and again we had some really young guys play, you know, in a big match at Hull at their home ground, and I thought they'd done really well again. So it shows that we've got plenty of depth, which is really good for the club.
I remember once Andrew Johns came over, I think in about 2005, much to my detriment, because he played against Leeds in the Smashers. And I remember Lee Breers and some of the guys talking about how we invested a little bit into the young guys, try to teach them. How much have you been involved with the youngsters, from yourself bringing your own expertise to the youth for Warrington?
Well, I mean, Joey took me under his wing to start with. You know, I was a youngster, I suppose, coming through the grades at Newcastle, and he was you know, one of the best players in the world at that stage. So, you know, he did show me a lot of things during training, outside of training hours. So he certainly invested, you know, a lot of his time in me, and I'm forever grateful for that, that's for sure. But I think, you know, Denny Bideris was another guy who I learned a lot of things off.
Me too.
Yeah, you know, a great leader, one of the toughest guys to have played the game, I believe. And, you know, so I learned a lot of things and leadership, and, you know, passing on my advice to younger guys from them. And I think I do that to the next group of players coming through. And you know, I think experience in the game and what sort of mentors I've had in my career, and I try and pass that on to the next generation as well.
Superb. We've just been outside. It's a bit wet, drizzly. That means it's October. It's almost ready for grand final time. I've been fortunate to experience it on a number of occasions now. Unfortunately, not this year for me, but there's a real opportunity for Warrington to go do something special, but you've got some big challenges to overcome. What are the next 2 weeks going to look like for you in the mentality-wise?
Good question. I mean, I think the biggest games have been controlled for me personally as a halfback. You know, making the right calls, getting through our sets, completing well, you know, kick chase, defending well. I mean, me as a three defender, as an edge defender, I think my job there is massively important to talking to my back row, my centre, my winger. So I think, you know, all the little things, I think the bigger the game, the more you've got to tick off the little things, and just effort as well.
Well, I want to thank you for your contributions in Super League this year, and
thank
a much-deserved place in the Dream Team. Well done.
Thanks
all the best
lot.
For the future as
thanks,
well.
Thanks.
Cheers. Thank you. Appreciate that. Thank you.